Hi everyone, welcome to AJ's classes for UGC NET. This video is on the number series, which is an important topic in paper 1. In this video, we're going to look at the different types of questions that come in the exam. So let's look at the first question. They've given us a series of numbers 1, 5, 9, 13, 17, and 21, and they've asked us to find the next term in the series. So the way to solve these type of questions is by finding a pattern between the numbers. The best way to do this is by taking the difference between the consecutive numbers. So let's take the first two numbers, 1 and 5. The difference is 4. The next two numbers, 5 and 9, the difference is 4 again. 9 and 13, again, the difference is 4. So as you can see, the pattern here is 4. 4 is added to every number to arrive at the next number. 13 plus 4 gives you 17. 17 plus 4 gives you 21. So to calculate the next term in the series, all you have to do is add 4 to 21. So 21 plus 4 gives you 25. So your answer is option B, 25. Okay, so let's look at the next question now. The series here is 1, 2, 4, 7, 11, and 16. So let's take the difference between the numbers again. As you can see, 2 minus 1 is 1, 4 minus 2 is 2, 7 minus 4 is 3, 11 minus 7 is 4, 16 minus 11 is 5. So as you can see, the difference is going in this order, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which means the next difference should be 6, right? So 16 plus 6 gives you 22. So the next term in the series is 22. So your answer is option A, 22. Okay, the next question, the series is 1, 4, 9, 16, and 25, right? So just by looking at these numbers, you would probably have guessed that they are squares, right? These are the squares of numbers. The square of 1 is 1, the square of 2 is 4, 3 square is 9, 4 square is 16, 5 square is 25, which means the next term in the series should be 6 square, right? Which is 36. So our answer is option C, 36. The next question. The series here is 2, 5, 10, 17, and 26. So if you look closely, you can see that it's similar to the previous question in the sense that they're the squares of numbers, but the number 1 has been added to all the squares, right? So if you look at the first number here, 2, it's basically 1 square plus 1. 1 square is 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. Then 5, the next number, 5, is 2 square plus 1. 10 is 3 square plus 1. 17 is basically 4 square. 4 squared is 16 plus 1 is equal to 17. And 26 is 5 square plus 1. So the next term in the series is 6 square plus 1, which is basically 6 into 6 is 36 plus 1. So your answer is 37. Option D, 37. Okay, the next question. The series is 1, 8, 27, 64, and 125. So looking at it, you can see that they are the cubes of numbers, right? 1 cubed is 1. 2 cubed is 8, 3 cubed is 27, 4 cubed is 64, 5 cubed is 125, which means the next term in the series should be 6 cubed. So 6, 6 are 36, 36 into 6 gives you 216. So our answer is option B, 216. The last question for this video, as you can see, the series here is a bit different than the other questions that we just saw. The numbers here are 6, 18, 9, 27, and 13.5. So as we did for the previous sums, we have to find a pattern between the numbers, right? So look at the first two digits, 6 and 18. We know that 6 into 3 is equal to 18, right? So now the next two digits, 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. 9 and 27, we know that 9 threes are 27. 9 into 3, gives you 27. Then 27 and 13.5. 27 divided by 2 is 13.5. So as you can see, they're following an alternating pattern over here, right? They're multiplying into 3 and dividing by 2. So since we just did 27 divided by 2, 13.5, the next term would be 13.5 into 3, which is basically 40.5. So our answer is option D, 40.5. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. Do subscribe to my channel, AJ's Classes for UGC NET, to stay updated on my latest videos.